The Montreal Canadiens power play has been firing on all cylinders over the past 20 games, and is mainly due to one player, a 19-year-old star in the making. This is Hadi Kalakesh breaking down how Juraj Slafkovský has revolutionized the Habs' man advantage and turned an important corner in his development. After watching Juraj Slafkovský's preseason and his first game of the regular schedule against Toronto, I put out this video on my channel where I broke down the drastic improvements in his tools and toolkit that would inevitably lead to better results for the former first overall pick. A quiet-ish first half of the season production-wise left some doubts in folks' minds, but when Slafkovský was reunited with Suzuki and Caulfield in mid-December, the floodgates opened. 23 points in his last 26 games, 13 in his last 10, and an active 8-game point streak. Safe to say, Juraj Slafkovský has hit a new level. Even more interesting than his numbers, Slafkovský has taken an often struggling power play in Montreal and turned it into one of the most effective man advantage units in the NHL. I'll be showing you how Slafkovský's move to the half wall and, more importantly, the things he does from that position have led to Montreal's power play success in recent games. Let's start with his most important contribution, retrievals. The first of three big issues of Montreal's top power play unit was a puck retrieval game. Their shots would almost always end up on opponents' sticks or fly out of the offensive zone. Slafkovský's improved awareness and anticipation, along with his pre-existing reach and physical game, have become a key tool in not only putting shots back onto his teammates' sticks, but also making his teammates less picky with their shots. The Habs aren't trying to find the perfect shot anymore, because they know Slafkovský is going to collect those rebounds and recycle puck possession sequences for them. The Habs' faceoff percentage on the power play has also improved, partly due to Slafkovský's involvement in post-faceoff puck battles. The vastly improved scanning habits I hinted at in my first video on Slafkovský earlier this year are a major factor in his efficiency in every type of puck retrieval scenario. When he heads into battles, he already knows where to push the puck and what power to put behind his rim passes to put the puck right into his teammate's path. Before the instincts comes the scanning. With the amount of reps Slafkovský's had to figure out his teammate's habits and routes, he barely even needs to scan anymore. He does it for good measure, but when he doesn't have the time to take a look and figure things out, he can just trust his gut. Stable and predictable line mates help Slafkovský figure out his instinctual game out at 5-on-5, and now, we're seeing that aspect translate to the power play. Hockey at its core, especially on the power play, is a shoot and retrieve game, and Slafkovský's retrieval game has helped the Habs be a force on the man advantage. Slafkovský. Caulfield on his back end. Slafkovský. Suzuki shoots and scores. He does it again. Nick Suzuki. Power play goal. 3-9. Next up, the passing game. Another big issue with Montreal's top power play unit was zone entries. If you watched any Habs game in the 2023 calendar year, you probably saw those drop passes to Nick Suzuki constantly turn into dump-ins in 50-50 battles. Suzuki didn't have a stable option to pass to on his right side, but now, he has Slafkovský, especially with how his passing game has grown over the past year. Slafkovský's biggest improvement passing-wise is his ability to figure out when to accelerate his pass release and when to hold on to pucks. His one-touch passing has become high-end, that's also solved the third big issue with Montreal's power play, circulation. The Habs will get stuck in ruts passing-wise. They'd get trapped into corners of the ice with no outlets to pass to, and as soon as teams pressured them aggressively, the puck would leave the offensive zone. Now, with Slafkovský in the mix, the Habs' power play puck circulation is a major strength. Slafkovský's even made himself the focal point of the Habs' puck circulation at times. He constantly commands the puck with his posture and positioning. He quickly identifies his next pass and doesn't hesitate nearly as much as he used to. Slafkovský's ability to blend his aforementioned puck retrieval game with his passing has also made him essential to Montreal's power play. He's also added some look-off passes, which help him connect with Alex Newhook in the bumper spot, and it's those improved scanning habits at work again. He doesn't see these plays as a step-by-step process. He's already thinking about the third step before getting to the first. Constantly receiving pucks in motion and thinking about what comes next, the word that comes to mind when watching Slafkovský on the power play is dynamic. To put it bluntly, Slafkovský lacked dynamism last year. He would catch pucks with his feet anchored, would force passes through players instead of misdirecting them, and rarely made a one-touch pass, if ever. This year is the complete opposite, and it's all thanks to his improved scanning habits and some very, very good coaching from Martin Saint-Louis. Bottom of the shot, hesitates,
gets it in. And Brad Suzuki scores! Nick Suzuki buries it power play goal in Montreal within one.
Slafkovský's usage of off-puck movement has also helped the Habs a ton when it comes to creating power play chances. At the net front, he alternates between playing goalie or sliding to the side for a pass option. With the constant rotation that's become a trademark of Alex Burrows' system, Slafkovský can go from left circle to net front to right circle in a span of seconds. Previously, he'd switched between these positions in a linear fashion. Now there's more nuance, communication, and awareness in those switches. On the half wall, we see the biggest change in Slafkovský's off-puck approach. These constant back-and-forth motions make him extremely hard to pick up, especially when Suzuki has the puck on the opposite flank. He's also been driving the net away from the puck fairly consistently. When Suzuki and Caulfield get a puck touched down low, he creates a ton of havoc with timely and powerful net drives. Previously, Slafkovský would park himself in an area and wait for a pass. Now he seeks those passes out with perpetual offensive motion. He moves into pockets of space before backing off of them and switches roles on the power play seamlessly. His net front game and half wall play are greatly aided by this new and improved approach to creating chances for himself without the puck. Although it's still a work in progress, the shooting threat that Slafkovský brings from the right circle has made the Habs power play a lot more multifaceted. Before that, Suzuki was playing on that side as the alternate threat to Caulfield's one-timer. He would circle up, catch a puck from Matheson, and fire a walk-in wrister from the circle. Now, with Slafkovský occupying that space, it allows Montreal to overload the opposite side with both Suzuki and Caulfield on their strong side. Both of them alternate between the left circle, the back door, and the back of the net, which frees Slafkovský up to do what we discussed a second ago, move off the puck and create havoc on the right side. This is a lead up to the goal that played in the video's intro. Slafkovský doesn't touch the puck until he's firing it into the back of the net, but when you watch closely, his routes, reads, and constant availability are the reason he got that puck in the first place. The shooting mechanics have certainly improved a bit, but the main reason for this uptick in goals is that Slafkovský's looking to shoot more often. He's getting more confident in his release, and he's constantly finding pockets of space. This extends to his even strength play too. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe, and leave your thoughts down below. Hattie out.